All right, so can you tell me your name and your title?
My name and my title, Jason Levitt.
Okay.
And I'm a writer, and I'm an engineer, and I am a... what is the other, the third thing? I had them figured out here. Because I'm sort of a generalist, so I'll say that.
Okay.
I'm a massive generalist.
Massive generalist, all right. And then your panel was just titled, The Comfy Chair, Are We Sitting Too Much?
Yes.
And so I want to ask you, why is it important to talk about whether we're sitting too much?
It's important because research findings only in the last 10 years, maybe 10 to 15 years, have unveiled some very interesting findings about the effects of sitting too much. And this is very important for people who sit a lot, which is almost everybody in the white collar world, anybody who uses a computer every day.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think it's important that that people know some of these findings. I think it's important for awareness. So it's strictly an awareness thing.
So you talked a little bit in the presentation about some of the misconceptions that sitting too much is lethal or it's as bad as smoking. Can you clarify some of those?
Well, those were two of them.
Yeah.
You see these in the media, New York Times headlines, commercial during Saturday Night Live. So one of them is that sitting is as bad as smoking. And we found that that was really a researcher that was saying something more like sitting is sort of the new smoking. He was kind of offhandedly saying this. And as far as I can tell, there's no study that says sitting is as bad as smoking.
Right.
And they certainly have a very different pattern of causality as far as diseases or problems are concerned.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of scary the way they use it in the media, and yet it's really not true at all. It's kind of, at the worst, it's apples and oranges. And then the other one is sitting, you know, leads to greater mortality, and the way they say it, it's very scary. You know, sitting is going to kill you. It's this path to death, and that also seems really overblown. And the studies that I've seen so far, at worst, they say, well, if you're sitting a lot of the time, 60% or 70% of your time or more, there is a correlation. And I think, and this is not real science, but observation, anecdotal observation, that we already have the causality of obesity with mortality. We know that obesity, if you weigh a lot more than is natural for your body, that's more likely you're going to die sooner. And we know from newer studies that sitting too much tends to lead to obesity. So then, of course, you're going to have studies that go, oh, yeah, sitting too much makes you die sooner. Because of that triangle.
Right.
So that's what I think is sort of happening. I don't think it's really that interesting by itself.
Okay.
It's good if it motivates people, well, there's some value there.
All right. So my last question for you is, with tech jobs becoming more and more common and a lot of people, you know, with the internet, people can just work online and from home, do you feel like it's becoming a bigger issue, this idea of sitting all the time, than it was, you know, 20, 50 years ago?
Yes, because 20, 50 years ago, people weren't sitting as much, nearly as much, and there was a lot more background activity in their lives. You had to do many more things manually. Even in an office, you had to get up and do a lot more things manually than you do now.
Mm-hmm.
Now you can really just sit. Your entire life can be sitting, communicating, ordering out for food. You don't have to do anything at all for hours at a time. So it's very different. It's very different now. And of course, we have all the research now. They've only really been doing studies on sedentary activity, you know, inactivity physiology in the last 20 years or so, really serious stuff.
Mm-hmm.
There's some little bits of stuff if you go back in the medical history before that, but only the last 20 years or so, they've really been focusing on it.
Cool. All right, well, thank you for your time.
You're welcome.